Hey guys, Jared, Transformational Coaching. Action is transformation. In this video, we're going to get into why you might get relationship anxiety. I got anxiety for years in all different aspects of my life. I never had too much anxiety related to relationship because I was always more of an avoidant personality given the bad relationship that I had with my mother growing up. And until you heal that wound, whatever that primary wound is, whether it's from your father or your mother, whether they were there for you or not there for you, once you heal that wound, you'll see any bit of avoidant anxiety or attachment anxiety in relationship. Today is one, just a little bit about my own personal experiences that following over the years, but then also some of my client stories, and then three key facts or ways of being or doing that you can use and apply to your own life in order to get over any relationship anxiety that you might be having. So without further ado, let's get into it. Also, before we get into it, if you like what you see here, please share, please subscribe, do whatever you want to if you feel inspired to and you really feel like you're getting the value that you want. Cool, let's get into it. So for years, me, myself personally, I always had an avoidant attachment style. And if you don't know what attachment styles are, check it out. I have it on my YouTube channel under the relationships playlist. But really all attachment style is just you either have avoidant or insecure, or you have a like an anxiety attachment style where you just need to cling. That's this topic of stage five clingers is something that men talk about and some women, but I haven't met too many of the ones who have that challenge in their life where they're clinging to a man. But some of them do. Some of them do. So really, when it comes to avoidance or any bit of clinginess in relationship, it always relates back to our childhood and our primary caregivers and how trustworthy they were in the initial relationship. Could we trust them to be there for us when we fell, when we would fall down? When I look back at my own relationships, I can see where I would always avoid relationships because I had an initial relationship with my mother that was very clingy. So I always felt suppressed and compressed in relationships. So I avoided relationships at all costs for many years until I started actually healing that wound and until I started to believe, wow, wait, maybe relationships can expand my life and make me a better human being and allow me to enjoy my life, which was never really a possibility until I went into that wound and did a lot of work around it. So what is one of the primary reasons as to why you might experience relationship anxiety? Well, the chances are that if you're experiencing any bit of a relationship anxiety, it's just pointing to what you still need to develop within yourself. Maybe it's financial independence. Maybe it's emotional independence. Whatever it may be, every single relationship that we have in our life serves a specific function, whether we're aware of it or not. And so if you got this anxiety within you when you connect with another person, it's pointing to some type of lack mindset or lack that you have within yourself. Perfect example of this, I was coaching one client 2 years ago, and she kept like clinging onto me, and I was like, man, there's some weird attachment stuff here. And it was because she didn't really have much money, and she could sense my financial abundance, and I could see that. And so I brought that up. I said, look, I feel like you're clinging to me. What's that really about? And then we actually went deeper into that. She got triggered. She realized that she had this attraction to me because of the financial independence that I had that she didn't have. And so then I said, well, why don't we make that the focus of our coaching and helping you create wealth, because that's what's coming up for you. So it's really important. It's really important to be aware of what is triggering anxiety within us in relationship, because that anxiety is pointing to something that you haven't worked out within yourself that it's time to work out. Every human being, whether they realize it or not, is always seeking ultimate freedom. And ultimate freedom is knowing that you have the ability to create whatever you want to create in your life, having the ability to make it happen, just going after it, but also not letting a sense of fear or worry or concern or lack holds you back. You know, for me, I can look back at my own life and see so many times where I had fear or anxiety or worry, and then I looked at that as a pointer to say, that's exactly where I need to go. You know, I love Tim Ferriss's idea of making a fear list. Yeah, make a fear list. Whatever you're scared of, go into that right away and then use that as a means to evolve, because every single human being, whether you realize it or not, on the planet wants to, their nature is to evolve to the greatest version of themselves. That's what I love doing about coaching work, is seeing an individual's potential and whether they're willing to step into that full potential or not, and allowing themselves to actualize into the fullness of the potential that they have. So if relationship anxiety is coming up for you, all that's pointing to is something that you haven't developed within yourself yet. Maybe it's financial. I can remember being in one relationship and latching on to the girl and being like, oh my God, I might fail at everything. And it was because I hadn't had developed financial independence, and I was looking at her towards that. And as soon as I saw that, I was like, I need to get out of this. I need to develop it myself. And then other times it was emotional. And so if there's that anxiety coming up for you, ask yourself, you know, what anxiety is coming up for me, and what's it directly connected and related to? Number two, and this is my personal favorite, you haven't learned to soften or harden your energies yet in order to create the connection. Our true nature as a human being is flexibility. Like, be like bamboo. You can be hard and really sting and put a punch there when you need to, but you can also be soft and flexible. And really, in the sales world, we call this style flexing. You know, when people are hard and resistant, they put up a wall, that's when you soften. You get really soft. Really, and you can do it. You can feel this emotionally. We all have this power. We just don't know it. You can really soften. Be really kind, loving, caring, open. Hey, I see this. I get this. I get you. Soften your being. Soften your energy. Or other times when there's a soft energy, you need to harden. You need to go masculine energy, full focus, full force, harden, break through. And so knowing how to soften, lean back, be loving, kind, and compassionate, and then harden and be forward, knowing how to switch in between those energies is incredibly valuable in creating any connection that you want in life. Most people are living in their personality. They're living in their personality, which is a hardened structure and a hardened way of response to the world. And they're not willing to compromise that personality because that feels like death. My friends, you are always dying all the time. I die like 20 times a day. I don't even, like, I'll be doing something. Who am I in this moment? And then I'll just do what I need to do, and then I'll be a completely different person. And that's normal. That's our natural state. When you start to identify with the awareness or consciousness that you really are, beyond thought structures, beyond emotional structures, when you identify with that pure consciousness being that you are, you can choose to harden and soften your energies as you see fit to create the energetic connection. When I look back at my past relationships, when I look at relationships from my clients, most of them are trying to have relationship through the personality. And that doesn't work. And it doesn't, well, it can work, but it's not going to be a deep, long-lasting, loving, fulfilling relationship because it's two personalities having relationship. It's not a free flow of consciousness, evolution, and transformation, which is really what actual relationship is about. And so when you identify with that natural evolutionary transformational process and you allow it, then the relationship can be formless and flow. It can be formed into some, it's always transmuting and always changing. And that's how we get to that state, is learning to harden or soften our energies as we see fit based off of whatever it is, whatever connection that we want to create. You know, sometimes, I'll be on a sales call or something like this, and a person comes at me and they're really hard. And I'll be like, okay, I just need to soften and listen. I just literally need to be a feminine container right now and just allow them to fall into my world. And then other times they have an entire, you know, they'll come at me in the feminine energy. I'm like, okay, I just need to go forward. And that's what I'll do. I'll go forward if I see what I have to offer is really helpful for them. So it's really knowing when to push your energies, be hard, be that strong foundational force and move things forward, or when to be soft, loving, receptive, feminine energy, and knowing how to push your energies, your life energies, into a hardened state, masculine state, or a soft, feminine, receptive state. That's going to give you so much more mastery over life, over your finances, over your emotional connections and your relationships. Really, that's it's cool to do that. It's really fun to play with that. So if that's something that, if that anxiety is something that you're seeing coming up in your relationship, it's probably just pointing to the fact that you don't have a mastery of your life energies yet, or your feminine energy or your masculine energy. And if that's the case, just soften. Well, one, you can reach out and connect with me because I can show you how to do that. But two, you want to learn how to do that because that's ultimate mastery, and that you're going to be able to enjoy your life a lot more when you know you have that sense of mastery. And finally, number three, deep down, you question your abilities to create and maintain and keep a healthy connection. Now, it's not all on you to create and can keep a healthy connection. A relationship is a dance of two. However, if you've mastered your masculine energies and your feminine energies, and you can soften and harden at will, which does take a lot of energy in and of itself to do that, then you're going to be able to consciously create connection as you see fit. And that's a big advantage. You have a big advantage over, I'd say, 90% of people on this planet if you know how to soften and harden your energies at will. Some people are doing this unconsciously. Others have no idea that it's not even possible, so they just feel stuck in a certain relationship, and the relationship is going sour, and it's not fun or enjoyable anymore. And if that's the case, well, it's time to learn how to soften and harden your energy so you can create whatever connection that you want. And when you can do that, you'll have a lot more confidence in your ability to create deep relationship and to maintain relationship. You know, when I look back at some of my relationships with clients and even romantic partners, I see where my personality was getting in the way. And then other times I was like, man, I didn't have a personality, and then I knew how to soften and harden as I saw fit to create a conscious connection. So really, if you feel like there's any anxiety coming up in your relationship, it's just an indicator, a pointer to what you still need to develop within yourself, and use it. You know, use that. Oh, cool. I just need to develop this part of my identity or this part of my being. Use that as a signal to your further evolution. That's what life's all about. It's about growing, expanding, learning more, transforming, and changing your consciousness and the consciousness of other people and the planet, which we are all a part of. That's what your body is. It's nothing more than a conscious piece of the planet walking around that your life energies have picked up to have an experience of. Cool. That's all I got for this time. Thanks so much for joining me, you guys. If you like what you've seen here, please share and subscribe. Also, sign up for the Sacred Relationship series that Laura and I are doing. The link is right there in the YouTube description box below. We'd love for you to be a part of it. We got about a month left of this. If you have any trouble, challenges, comments, concerns, gripes, or complaints, feel free to put them in the YouTube comments. I always respond. It usually takes me 24 hours to. I'd love to hear your thoughts and your comments. That's all I have for this time. Thanks so much for joining me, you guys. Have a wonderful and lovely day. I will see you all very soon. Bye for now.